I just called him out of the blue and I have no idea if he will actually answer. Oh, you're here. What's up, man?
Hello.
Hey, man. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm very good. Thank you. Yeah, it's probably easier if you mute the stream. I don't know if you have the stream open, but...
I just muted it, yeah.
Yeah, like the stream delay is always very confusing. There's always going to be like delay. All right. Cool. So we're on the NA server, if I'm not mistaken, right?
Yes, actually, sir.
Are we?
Yep.
Cool. Yeah, you mentioned that you were from the US, but you're in Vietnam or whatever.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm actually on NA. Wait, I'm on NA? Oh, wait, I'm actually in Legacy of the Void. Apparently, it is considered the NA server. Interesting. Anyways, man, how's StarCraft been going? Have you had any good times lately?
Yeah, playing a lot of games. Frustrated. All last season I was at top gold for maybe a month, and then I just get a little frustrated because it seems like I would beat people that are in gold league, but anytime somebody has actually gotten to platinum league, it's very rare that I would beat that person, and it's just like, man, what am I doing that's not getting me there?
Mm-hmm.
And I put in a lot of games. I put in a ton of games. I love the game. I play with my buddy who's in the chat right now, Doug. So it's a great way for me to stay connected with my friends at home, too. So, love StarCraft.
Okay, that's awesome. Yeah, there's definitely a bit of a bridge between, like, Gold and Platinum League. Well, you already mentioned you were high Gold, but there's, like, a massive difference in skill as well in Gold League, especially. But there's, like, one step between each of the leagues, you know?
Yeah.
And Gold League basically could be split up in like three different leagues if you really wanted to, but
yeah, it's a massive league, a ton of people inside of it.
Yeah, it's I believe it's 40% of all players or something in Gold, and then Bronze and Silver are actually smaller than that, so it's a bit of a mess, but that's all fine. Could you join Group Loco TV in game, or are you already in?
I'm in here. Yep.
Cool. Smoking guns. Damn.
Smoking guns. I should have been a Terran player with a name like that, but...
Yeah. Cool. From the Rust Leaguers. Cool. Alright, so what I'm gonna do... You did mention you have seen some of the coaching before, right?
Yes.
Yeah. For some people in the chat that are not aware, basically we'll be playing a couple of games. In between we will have a look at the replay and talk about the things that we could change up. And then we'll just jump into the next one. As of right now, I'm just checking out the career summary really quickly to see how things have been going. Yeah, so you started off... Have you been playing for a long time? Or has it mostly been... account is starting out of the Swarm, but...
I played for a long time, like a lot of 2v2 with my friends back home. And then I started playing a lot of 1v1 after actually finding your YouTube channel, Things with Doug.
Thanks,
you made me feel really competitive about it. I was like, wait, no, I want to smoke people in one-on-one, no 2v2. So a lot of one-on-one the last maybe 3 or 4 months.
All right. Yeah, so you did start in Wings of Liberty or in Heart of the Swarm?
Heart of the Swarm.
Okay.
I played Brood War back in the day.
All right.
But I not like, it was always just like BGH and not really serious.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So, yeah, you found out how awesome 1v1s are. That's cool.
Exactly, yeah.
1v1 is great. Cool. All right. Yeah, so you've been playing 1v1 for about 4 seasons, it says, and you started off in silver. Right now you're up to gold, which is good. Oh, yeah, you do play quite a bunch of games. That's good. Nice. All right. So, as of right now, you have 47% versus Protoss. 43% against Terran, and 50% against Zerg. Cool. Would you say that like your Zerg versus Terran, do you feel the weakest in there as well, or is it all just?
Yeah, that's kind of what I wanted to work on today. I know that we're gonna do 3 of these sessions, so I figured maybe we would do 1 on each race, and I think that would be how I'd get the most out of it. So I definitely want to start with Terran today.
All right. Yeah, we can definitely do that. Usually, it's the easiest to. Especially if you have, like, 3 of them, right? It's easiest to work on one matchup at a time and then have, like, a week or 2 in between. So you can, like, work on a couple of things. A lot of the skills, at least, like, macro-wise, which is what you put in the email, carry over to the other matchups as well. But it's good to have, like, a certain focus. Should make it a little bit easier. How are you enjoying the new map pool, by the way? You actually have a really solid win on Cactus Valley, surprisingly enough. That's actually a difficult map.
Is that the four that you start off with, four bases on each corner?
Yeah, like the massive map. Like, it's huge.
Yeah, I enjoy it. It gives me a little space. That's probably my biggest problem, probably why I'm successful in that, is especially with Terran. It's just like, all of a sudden, it's like, oh my god, how did he get so many Marines, and how does he keep pouring them on? Mm-hmm. So, with the space, it's nice.
Alright. Yeah, it's actually interesting. Most people have trouble playing on the bigger maps. You actually have 67% win on Cactus Valley, and all the other ones are just below 50. Which is actually pretty big, considering you do play a lot of games, so it's a nice statistic to have a look at as well. It seems especially on, like, the smaller the map gets, the harder of a time you're having.
Yeah, like, Expedition lost against Terran, it's brutal for me.
Mm-hmm. Cool. Alright, well, maybe you can figure that as well. Yeah, I'll just write... I'm basically making a whole bunch of notes. And I'll send those to you after coaching as well, so you can see something, or you can, like, you know, see what I wrote down as well.
Okay.
Cool. All right, do you have, like, one specific goal in mind that you really want to achieve, or is it you just want to play the game and see how high you can get?
I'd like to play the game and see how high I can get.
Mm-hmm.
Right. I would like to have that diamond border one day. That would make me feel very good.
Cool. I think that's reasonable. Especially now that they like reworked a whole bunch of the leaks. Well, to be fair, the leaks are kind of a mess right now, but apparently like a whole lot of the pro gamers are stuck in gold or in diamond.
That was like when the new season popped out, it was just I was like, I thought I was top gold and I was just getting smoked in gold league, and then you're checking it out and it's master, diamond players, and you're like, okay, this is not okay.
Yeah, exactly. Alright. So cool. So the weakest matchup statistically speaking would be Zerg versus Terran. Yeah, let's just start off with that one.
Okay.
So the easiest way to do this is either to have a look at a replay or to have a look at to just play a game right away. I don't know if you selected a couple of replays. I've been talking to so many people about coaching and think I'm missing it.
I preemptively, I have one that just happened the other day. Cool. And it was brutal. So I can load that up.
Yeah, that'd be cool. Yeah, if you could host up the lobby, I just pass you the lead. And then actually in the lobby, toss the lead back. It's a bit of a mess, but else I can't control the replay.
Okay.
What is the group called in StarCraft 2? It's just Loco TV. That's actually a whole lot of people in there right now. Yeah. So I don't know if you want to play against Doug or if he's a Terran player.
No, he's a Zerg player. All right. I don't want to play against Doug. Oh, sorry. I don't know what I just did here.
No worries. Yeah, we're likely going to need someone to play against. So if you are a Terran player right now in the chat, or, you know, you're good with Terran, and you're right around, like, Gold League, or maybe like low platinum or something, feel free to join the group over on the North American server. It's LOWKO TV. Yep, I'm on the chat right now as well. So you should, if there's a guy named Loco Loco, then it's me. It's just so we can speed things up a little bit, because there's always a lot of waiting and stuff. Cool. Alright. So talk me through the game. Do you have like do you remember the game or?
I do remember it a little bit. I believe that I put out some scouting. I saw he's got a few Marines. He's coming for me. I was like, okay. I think I skipped speed and I went straight in to get into Bane lanes, popped a few Bane lanes, and when he came in the front door, I busted him, and then it was just drop city bitch, drop city bitch.
All right.
It was crazy.
Yeah, one sec, please, because for whatever reason, I hear all kinds of crackling. I think that's my audio interface, so I'm going to reset it real quick.
Okay.
All right. Can you say something?
Yep.
All right, cool. Yeah, that happens every now and then. I don't really know why. All right. So a lot of drops and a lot of multitasking and aggressive Terran play, pretty much.
Yeah.
Okay. Dude, I love the car. Is that like an old Beetle?
Yeah, it is.
Awesome.
It's our Rust League.
Oh, right, it's Rust League. Okay, cool. I see. Oh man, I've been playing so much Legacy of the Void lately that opening up with so few workers looks so weird.
Right, like, it looks cool when you're expanding at 1 minute. That's awesome.
Yeah. It's funny because when you think about it, when you look at these replays, the first couple minutes, nothing happens anyway. So it's not like missing out on anything.
Think about all the time you're going to get back in your life, Loco.
Yeah.
Skip those 2 minutes of those games.
Well, you can play like two games more an hour. It's not. It's actually quite nice. Like if you play a lot of games, it does make a pretty big difference. All right, so you were like, fuck, I want to go pool first. And they were like, nope, hatchery. That's fine. So what do you usually have in mind? Do you like playing Mutaling Bane mainly, or is it more like Roach Hydra?
If he goes bio, it's Mutaling Bane, which 15 hatch, 15 pool, 17 gas, 17 overlord.
Mm-hmm.
Then 100 gas, Ling, speed. And then I think the next one I usually try to get, depending on how aggressive he's being, I'll try to go Lair and then Bane Lane.
Okay.
And then from there, if I can, this has been my problem with Terran, is I feel like they put so much pressure on me. It's even hard for me to get to the point where I actually get like a Mutalisk going. Because I'm like defending the entire time. I swear to God, they like just have like an unlimited supply of Marines.
Okay, yeah. So you're having trouble with constant aggression, right? And it's probably the same thing when they go for how you call them, like Banshee play and like Hellion into Banshee play and all these kind of things, right?
Yeah, or Hellion into Firebat even. Because then you're constantly pumping gas into Bane lanes.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like, I need to get these Mutalisks up, but I also don't want to die in the process.
Yeah. All right, yeah, I totally understand that issue. It's actually something that it's mainly because Mutaling Bane is a very hard to control composition, especially early on versus Hellions and whatnot. Like Queens and Zerglings are beautiful against Hellions if you control it really well, but controlling it really well is really difficult. Mm-hmm. So that may be something we wanna try out, or at the very least like try and play a game where we go for like Roach Hydra, just to see how you feel about it.
Okay.
Just because like the Mutaling Bane control is tough. It's like it's like the best way to play, generally speaking. If you watch all the pro gamers, they would pretty much all do it. But it really works well if you're going to be controlling it near perfect as well. But we can have a look. We can just try both.
Okay.
All right. So are you actually skipping the Zerking speed on...
I did because he was there, and I was like, I need Banelings.
All right. Fair enough.
Maybe I could have handled that with those queens. Maybe I got a little bit...
Yeah, I think so, but yeah, a lot of safeness. Sorry, if you don't plan on doing anything with the links, it doesn't matter all that much. Alright. So the first thing I'm noticing, at the very least, is mainly a lack of like map vision right now. Like, if you have a look at your map vision right now, you have the overalls like positioned really well, and you like know close to your base about what is going on. But then close to his base, he could be moving out right now with a bunch of Marines, and we wouldn't know about it until he's already at your side of the map, right? And that's just, it's not completely necessary. But we can have a look at that.
So put a Ling there?
Yeah. I would put a Zergling here like every single time, no matter what. Like always have some sort of vision over here. And specifically on maps like this, which may actually be the reason why you're having trouble on these kind of maps. There's no watchtowers or anything like covering the middle part, right? Like you can't see this if it wasn't for the fact that, you know, you have a Zergling over there. There's no like overlord high grounds or anything like that. So you need to have something to see if there's moving out.
Okay.
Yeah, I guess not right now, forgetting the Zergling speed sucks. Making a heck of a lot of Zerglings, but no Link speed yet. Yeah, there we go. You're like, oh shit. Fair enough.
I was like, these are not fast. These are very slow.
Alright, the double Evo, got the Lair. Got the third base. I like the droning up though, but yeah, like we're definitely missing that vision. You see, like, there's no vision of right now if he's moving out or not. So these. Whoa, we're going for a Nidus? Alright. I like that, actually.
I figured he had the front block, so I wanted to surprise him.
Okay. Yeah. I like the cool strategies. Ugh. Ugh. All right. So one real quick tip for engaging any kind of Terran. I know it's scary to wait right here, but always, always try and get them on the creep, okay? There's really no reason right now to fight right there. I know it's just a matter of patience, but you want to move in like right when he's attacking your hatchery or something. Like, there's no reason to go off creep. It's just giving him extra movement speed, right? Or it's actually like giving him more time to split up the Marines. Because right here, like, a whole bunch of stuff dies that pretty didn't need to die.
Okay.
But that's just something to keep in mind. Like, whenever you see a Terran player do anything, just try and never engage him off creep, if you can. Damn Terran players.
They are, they're so mobile.
Yeah, and I'm missing vision right now of the third base as well. Because you don't know right now at this point if it's an all-in or if it's,
or if it's expanding. Like,
yeah, exactly. Yeah. I do like the aggressive droning, though. It's good.
What would be the answer to that, even if I see he's doing this, I'm still not doing well in this situation here. Mm-hmm. So what would it tell me if I knew that he's, if he's expanding or not? I'm still kind of in the same situation, right?
Yeah. So the main thing it would tell you, like, the main thing it would tell you is that he is pretty much completely all in if you wouldn't see a third base right now. So you can sort of assume, like, if I manage to clean this up, I will be able to take the game. As far as, like, the actual cleaning up part goes, it's all going to come down to queen injects mostly. We're flooding, like, 1.6k 700 minerals right now. And that's obviously going to be the main issue. Where it's simply, you know, just too much in the bank right there. Actually, same goes for the Terran player right here. But that's like, how many Zerklings is that? That's like 4 Zerklings times 17. It's a heck of a lot of Zerklings. Should not be doing math right now, but you know, it's like the potential of units you can make from the bank you have is huge. So yeah, just definitely hitting those queen injects and making the macro hatcheries and stuff would help.
So in that situation, I felt like I wasn't hitting the queen injects in the macro hatch exactly, so I should have just thrown down another hatchery inside my base while I'm defending this, because I know I need to produce those units.
Yeah, exactly. Like, basically, you can consider those 2,000 minerals you have right now basically as, like, you know, dead weight. There's absolutely no value to it if it's not being used, right?
Right.
So
if it was used, this would be a different game.
Yeah, exactly. Like, I would rather like see maybe 2 macro hatcheries even. I mean, you don't see pro gamers do that, but it's just because they're, you know, you can assume a pro gamer is going to hit their injects, but don't be afraid to, like, add on a macro hatch or whatever. It's totally fine to do. One other option would be to simply use less larva, which is also another reason to try, like, the Roach Hydra stuff. By simply having a Roach Warren up, obviously you're not going to need as much larva to actually defend these drops, because, you know, Zerklings aren't that expensive, whereas roaches will be more cost efficient as far as larva goes. Does that make any sense?
Yeah.
So yeah, I think it's gonna be good to give this Roach Hydra a try.
Against bio even.
Yeah, against bio it's fine as well. The only point at which point, or the only moment where it's gonna be bad, is once they finish up like 3-3 upgrades. And that all of a sudden completely, like, switches, like, the advantage to the Terran player. So that's, like, the one disadvantage of playing Roach Hydra. If they manage to get to +3/+3, it's very difficult to play. You might need some, you know, some other units, or to switch into Ultras or something like that. Mm-hmm. But up to 3-3, it's definitely very, very, very strong.
Okay. Why do pro gamers stay away from it then?
The main reason why you don't see it in pro games is because, well, you see it sometimes. I don't know if you saw Snoot versus Bunny. A couple weeks ago at the WCS, they played this match for the semifinals, I believe it was. But Snoot actually did this build, like, or not this build, but he played Roach Hydra twice versus him. It is, like, you don't see it too much. And the main reason why you don't see it too much is because, you know, exactly like I mentioned, once Terran players do get to 3-3, you will be able to, they will be able to just, you know, overpower it. And, you know, that's why Mutaling Bane is going to be better in the long run, because the Ultras will go a little bit nicer with it when you have T3 upgrades, you know?
Yeah.
So if you have a reasonable chance of going to the late game, it is better to play Mutaling Bane, as long as you actually manage to spend the minerals and the gas and whatnot. Whereas I feel like Roach Hydra is just easier to play. And you know, just better to focus on when you're still like really working on the macro aspects and stuff.
Okay.
It's just something we can give a try, and if it doesn't work out, we can.
No, I'm not disappointed in it at all. All
right.
No.
Have you ever played Roach Hydra versus Terran or like versus Bio at all?
I did in like the early games, and I was getting like schooled, and so I was like, okay, well, there's got to be something else. Then I saw everybody's doing Ling Bane, and I'm like, okay, that must be the answer.
Okay. Yeah.
And I do. I mean, I guess I'm only what 40 some odd percent, and it seems that most Terran players do go Bio, so that's. I guess I'm 40% with the Ling Bane. Mm-hmm. But obviously because I'm not capable of doing the macro and the skilled micro at the same time.
Yeah, it's just a different kind of practice. And, you know, if anyone's going to, like, make you do weird strategies, I'll be there. Like, yeah, so this is just fucking hard to, like, do anything against, right? Like, he doesn't even need to pick up right here, to be honest. He could just... Well, there we go. Now he would need to. But it's just a tough situation here. Because basically what's happening is he's, like, deciding the game, right? Like, there's more drops incoming. Actually, a couple Marauders rallied across and, like, more drops incoming right there. And he's just, like, constantly harassing. And that drop in the main base is still there. So it seems like you're being run around a lot. And that's, like, it sucks to be in that situation. Whereas with, like, Roach Hydra, I feel like you're more in charge of the game.
Okay.
Yeah. This is just very annoying. Brutal, I know exactly the feeling, yeah. All right.
So
I think I'd probably
GG out of here at some point. So.
Yeah, let's just quit the replay and just play a game and see what happens.
Okay.
So what we can work on is like doing some aggressive moves versus Terran as well. Now the only disadvantage of live streaming a coaching session is that your opponent will know exactly what you're gonna do.
Okay. Are you talking about your early Baneling Roach build that you would do, where you kind of make it look like you're doing a? You even get your third base at 6 minutes, but you don't do anything with it, and you move out.
We can try that one as well. I feel like that one is a little bit all in, but we can have a look at that as well later if you'd like to.
I've tried it. Whatever you want to do.
All right. Yeah, I would focus on macro first, just so I have like a standard, like a strong place to work from, and then we can also work on some all ins if you'd like to. But like that two base all in, it's or like you know technically a three base all in is really really powerful, but it's. You don't want to do it every game, you know? Like, if you do it every single game, it's just going to leave your ZVT, like, awfully.
Yeah, right. I'm not all about all-in, so I'm cool. All
right. Let's see if there's any gold-level Terrans players in the chat right now. There should be at least one, guys. Come on now. Oh, wait. Bronze and gold almost looks the same, doesn't it?
Yeah, very similar.
Alright, yeah, if there's any gold level Terran players right now in this stream, feel free to go to Group Loco TV on the EU server, or NA server rather, sorry, North American server. Okay, Frozen Chunk seems to be wanting to join in the chat, so that's cool. Yeah, so what we can do is go for, I uploaded it under like the easy Zerg build order, I don't know if you've ever seen that.
I might have. I think I've seen a ton of your videos, so I can't imagine I haven't.
All right. I can just talk you through it. Basically, the goal of the build, or the goal of the strategy, is to move out when you hit +1/+1 on your roaches, and then once again when you hit +2/+2 on the roaches, and then it transitions to
the two base roach build.
Yeah, exactly.
I think it's dubbed a loco build. I think that's.
Is it? I didn't know that. I feel honored, man. Alright, we got Raid Dagger in here, so that's, I'm a random / Terran player at gold level. But yeah, I'll just talk you through the build, and we can go from there.
Okay.
So the first game, I will just try my best to talk as much as possible, and then the second one, I will likely try and shut up, and see if it made any sense.
Okay.
But yeah, obviously we're playing custom games, so we can just pause the game whenever we want. But just keep in mind with this build, we want to try and move out right when +1/+1 and Roach speed finishes, and then right when +2/+2 finishes.
Okay.
All I don't know if you're actually gold, dude. Yeah, Zerg player at gold? Alright, we can invite you. It doesn't really matter all too much for the first game anyway. Alright. There's a lot of Europeans tuned in right now. It's like early morning in NA, so there won't be too many Americans up. Actually, it's like noon, I think. Alright, any map preferences besides Cactus Valley?
No, we can do the one that I was getting schooled on, Expedition Loss. I have a problem with that map, so.
Cool. Yeah, there's a lot of Americans tuned into the stream right now. They're at work and stuff. Alright. So what we're gonna do, I hope he has muted the stream by now. Hopefully. We never know. But anyways, it doesn't really matter.
Yeah, I mean, he knows I'm doing the two-based roach move. I mean, if yeah. He was listening. Yeah. But it's cool.
If he randomly makes like 4 siege tanks by like the 5-minute mark, we know we know he's aware of it, right? Like it has happened, man, where people like do it anyway and like, oh no, I wasn't listening, I swear. Like, yeah, sure, man. Like
right. They just want to be E famous.
But yeah. Did he see? All right. It's muted already because it is streamed as hacks and I hate hackers. All right, fair.
Passion.
Cool. All right, so what we're going to do is open up with 4 queens early on and then make the double guess at 5 minutes, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And then when we have 100 guests, we transition to watch the lair, a roach war and evo chambers. I will just obviously mention this in the game as well, but just to give you like an idea. So at 100 guests, we will... So 4 queen opener, double guess at 5 minutes. And then once we start up the lair, you also start up the Roach Warren and the double evos. And then 2 more guests in the natural as well. And then we start +1/+1 and roach speed. And after we hit max saturation, you want to make only roaches and then move out.
Okay. And do I need to throw in a couple lings somewhere in there just to protect from reapers? Okay. Well, yes. I'll have the queens, but yeah, okay.
Yeah. We're gonna make like 1 set of or 2 sets of Zerglings early on. After like defending Reapers or, you know, Marines or whatever, you want to try and do a little bit of scouting with them. And if you do you oftentimes feel like really scared early game in versus Terran, or do you usually feel pretty comfortable, like early on?
I'm fine. I play in Gold League. I expect everybody to rush, so I'm just used to that by now.
Yeah, so what we can do is just add a macro or like a spine crawler in there as well, just for a little bit more safety. Okay. And then like the next games, we can look at scouting and whatnot. I'll just secretly do that in this game, okay?
Okay.
I'll watch mainly the game just from your vision as well. But yeah, I can obviously look around. Yeah, just to see how this one feels, okay? So it's a bit of a different strategy, and you can definitely reach Diamond League with this just fine. It's really like top master, I feel like, where you're gonna have to play more Mirrorling Bane aggression, I suppose.
I used this build to get to Gold League from Silver. And then when I got here, I just felt like I was getting schooled a lot, but maybe that was by Protoss, which definitely needed some Hydras in there, so
yeah, definitely. Yeah, so we can also transition to Hydras with this one, but versus Protoss it works a little bit differently. I feel like it works really nicely against Terran, even if it's just for the fact that they don't expect it. Yeah, it's just a nice little way of playing. Oh shit, we see the APM right away, dude. It's good.
I know, my APM always looks so, people are like, why is your APM so high, but I just beat your ass. Like, I'm not doing anything.
It's the same, man. If you upload YouTube videos, like, oh my god, how the fuck is he spamming so much? Like, why? Like, it's just a habit. Like, I can't really stop it.
No, right. I tried to slow it down, and I just lost. So I was like, okay, I'll just keep this up.
Yeah, so the only thing to say about that is that, like, if you're, like, forcing yourself to do a lot of APM or, like, playing half in panic mode, it's a bad thing. But other than that, it should be no problem at all.
No, I have to... force myself to stop, like slow down, so right. I feel like it's more natural than anything.
Good. Yeah, I noticed with myself when I started like trying to up my APM, I was spamming a lot. I'll admit it.
What am I doing?
And I was like playing half in panic mode all the time. it was not a good way to play. So as long as it doesn't like make you do dumb things, it's fine. But yeah.
Loco, I forgot what you said because I've been doing the hatch first against Terran. You wanted me to go spawning pool first, right?
Let's go hatchery first as well. Let's go like 15 hatch.
Okay.
And just try and play a normal game for the most part. It doesn't matter if there's like some slip ups or whatever. I understand it's different when you play it by yourself or when you play with a couple hundred people watching.
I wasn't really thinking about it until you said it, Loco.
Oh,
so.
Fuck. Oh, my sincere apologies. Oh, man. The misplaced hatchery.
No. I do it every day. Welcome to my world.
No. No, but I know it's different. It's just different when someone's, like, watching everything you're doing and stuff.
Yeah, I wanted to say, I thought it was really cool. You know who the rapper Lil Wayne is?
Uh-huh.
I think Lil Wayne became famous because he started like filtering his music out online for free. And I feel like that's kind of what you've done with your YouTube videos. Like you've just put so much content out there that it's no wonder you have so many viewers. Oh, yeah. I didn't even need to build that.
That's fine. Yeah, we got a little bit too many overlords in this one. But thank you.
Yeah, sorry.
Yeah, no, like, making overlords, don't worry too much about it. Making no overlords is the worst thing in the world. Not making overlords, or like, you know, not making overlords bad. Being over in supply is not as bad, I suppose. Just try and squeeze out, like, two queens and, like, two sets of zerglings. Definitely prioritize queens, though. So, basically, the idea is, either you open up pool first or hatchery first. Just try and make four queens as fast as you can. That's basically the idea. Alright, and I would make like one or two sets of zerglings right now. Oh man, we got so many overlords out already. That's cool. Alright, micro times. Yeah, so instead of like making those two drones right when the spawning pool finished, it's probably a little bit easier to make zerglings instead, but...
Yeah.
It's all fine. Just queue up the next queens. And now back to droning again. We should have plenty. Okay. Queen inject times. Good. I like the hotkeys. Oh. Well, that's sweet of him. He didn't need to do that. Cool. Alright. So let's get to 36 supply as fast as possible. That's usually when you make the double gases. Now, if you play it perfectly, you can actually hit that at 5 minutes exactly. So you can see, like, we're a little bit behind right now because of the Reaper arrest. But yeah, let's go for the double gas right around right now.
I'm sorry, I didn't hear you at first, I'm sorry.
Oh, no, so, that's okay. That's okay. So try and get that Zergling in front of his ramp as well if you can find the APM to do so. Spending wise is going really well so far, so it's all good. Okay. So it's going to be really important to hit pretty much every single queen inject, okay? So we want to see if we can hit those like 90% of the time.
Okay. Yes.
Now this situation, since we're a little bit delayed, I would just make the Roach Warn a little bit earlier as well. Just because it's a little bit scary to not have it.
Why am I building it over there?
It's fine. Oh, we're going for the Wall Off, that's good as well. Alright, so you want to start up the Lair? And then another Evo Chamber, I suppose. Okay, nice. So one more Evo Chambers, and then we'll get the double gases in the main too. So far it's looking really good, dude.
You want me to build two more double? You want me to double gas again?
Yep.
Okay.
And then we're gonna start the missile upgrades and the armor upgrades.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Well, we can make a couple more overlords and make sure the gases are saturated. Okay. Yeah, you got plenty of APM. That's for sure. That's good. Okay. Want to start plus one armor. And also want to be starting Roach Speed. And then whenever you see at this moment where you're going to start flooding minerals, make sure to start taking up a third base right around this time as well. All right.
And this is a little bit beyond the normal 6 minute mark.
Yeah.
Is this on time or am I slow for this one?
It's about a half minute to about a minute late. Kind of depends on exactly how things going, but it's all right. So what we want to do next exactly is make a bunch of overlords and then make a whole bunch of roaches. Yeah, so don't worry too much about scouting this one. I'm using my secret map hacks to know exactly what's going on.
Okay. I sent him anyway. I hope that's okay.
Yeah, obviously. Nah, but I'm just saying, like, for this one, we don't need to focus on that. So let's like, make a lot of roaches. So the idea is, if you go to your roach one real quick. Okay. Oh, yeah. Hit the index first.
Okay.
So if you look at those upgrades, they will all finish up roughly around the same time. So that's when we want to like move across the map. So we can actually have a lot more though. Like we definitely need to get this mineral down. There we go. And I believe the main base is not injected yet. Cool. But yeah, that's the basic idea of it. So right now you want to start moving out. And yeah, usually we would have a couple more roaches here, but that's just going to be a couple practice attempts. Now while you're moving out. Oh well, he's actually attacking you, so I would actually defend right now. See the minimap?
Ah.
Cool. Well, can surround it, I suppose. That works. Alright. Just attack move in it, yeah. Okay, and get that money down. Very good. Okay. Gonna have to send a couple of those roaches towards the main base.
Okay.
And you can actually attack with the other half if you can find the APM to do so. So we need a couple roaches in the main for defense.
Okay, yep. Go on.
Okay. Okay. So I think at this point, you're fine as far as defense goes. So you can actually start making drones for the third base as well. It's a little bit of a multitask thing, but it's fine. I think you can handle it. Oh, no, that was... Ooh. The army that was attacking is suddenly moving back again, dude. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, the drops are happening, but this is what we wanted, right? So that's cool.
Oh, that's pretty nice of him. He backed off.
Yeah, I think he's going for the third. Okay, good. Okay, very nice. Just split up those roaches. You don't have to. Yeah, don't have to have like a whole group of them. There we go. Very good.
Okay.
Yeah. Just send like half of those roaches towards the main. Or well, there we go. I think you already won the game. Okay. Well, there's a couple reinforcing roaches right there. Just use those for defense. Very good. There we go. Just don't put them on a hotkey. I think that's the easiest thing to do. Like, don't put them on a hotkey, and we're good.
Okay.
Very nice, dude. Alright, so considering that was like the first attempt, and there was definitely, like I'm sure you noticed that as well, there was definitely still room for improvement, that was not even close. Let's be completely frank here, like, that wasn't even close, you completely won easy peasy right there.
Yeah. Yep, that was good.
I don't think I actually have too much to say, except there's like, you know, a couple things that,
Yeah, I think just because I was nervous, I hit the W instead of the Q and pumped out some overlords in the wrong place. I don't know why I went to hotkey those roaches at the end. Mm-hmm. Maybe it's because normally I wouldn't be like, okay, I'm going to send some to attack and some to defend. So when I have them all on the hotkey one, I was like, oh, this isn't working out.
Yeah.
So I was trying to split them. What is your recommendation for that? Because I obviously was butchering that.
I love the fact that you were actually using the hotkeys for your army, right? Most people that I coach in Gold League are using the select all army hotkey, and I'm like 90% sure you weren't using that, right? Please say no.
No, I wasn't.
Okay.
The only time I use that is when I need, like, maybe I made some and I forgot to hotkey them and I just need to get them back into a group.
Yeah, exactly. So that's what you want to do. So whenever they start dropping like this, the easiest thing to do, I think, is to just simply unhotkey a couple. So I think...
Shift-click them like I did with the Zerglings early on?
Yes, exactly.
Okay.
So what you can do is like leave like four in the natural, four in the main, and four in the third. Because you can see he's going to drop and pick up and then drop somewhere else. And honestly, like, as long as he's unloading and you're on top of it with a couple of roaches, you will be able to just pick off whatever is going on anyway. Like, the Marines are not going to unload fast enough for them to really deal with like four roaches. So just leave a couple in each mineral line and then focus on the attacks and back to the macro. It's a bit of a different way of defending, but honestly, it's pretty straightforward once you really know how to not hotkey an army. it's kind of strange at first, but it works very well.
My queens run around all the time. If I hit the hold position, they will stay. I feel like when I do hit the hold position, they still move.
If you hit hold position, they stay right where they are at that
really?
Point.
Really? Okay, not even if, like, I was, like, for example, I'm going through and I'm, I have them on five, so I'm five shift X, and I hit it on a hatchery that doesn't have a queen.
Mm-hmm.
The other ones will stay where they're supposed to stay, though, because they're on hold, right?
Yes.
Okay,
the one that's closest by will start moving. So
even
the one that's closest
on
by
hold.
And has energy will start moving, yes.
Okay.
Do you use the camera hotkeys, or were you hitting the space bar for, like, base camera?
I do space bar.
All right, what you might want to try and start using is the camera hotkeys as well. That's going to be kind of something to practice, like, you know, in between coaching or something. But basically where you have, like... Sorry?
I originally started out doing the camera hotkeys.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel like the five-shift space bar is much more comfortable and a lot quicker for me.
Yeah. I actually use both. It's like it both has different uses. Once you're really comfortable with the F1, F2 stuff, as long as you have it centered on a hatchery, like the drops are really easy to deal with as well. Because, for example, you see like a red mark on the minimap, you can just see, okay, that's in my natural F2, go defend with the roaches that are right there. Instead of like hitting spacebar and hoping that it will land on the natural, right? It's a bit confusing. So that may be something you want to implement. I know some people hate playing with it, and other people like absolutely love playing with it. I personally actually really enjoy it, but I would just recommend just giving it a try, and just see if you prefer it or not. I would definitely keep using the queen injects that you've been doing right now as well, though.
Okay, I got away from using the camera hotkeys, but I should set them. I know I should. Because that is where you're like, you need to send something to your main base. I'm like, I need to get to my main base. So just F1.
Yeah. It will help you with these drop plays as well.
Yeah.
But other than that, it was actually very good. Like the APM, you're plenty fast for Gold League for sure. You were not having any trouble with like the amount of things you needed to do. The aggressive droning was solid. Even though a couple of Reapers or a couple drones were lost at the beginning right there. That was not that big of a deal because you followed it up with like another 50 drones or something like that. Solid droning. I liked it a lot. That was good.
Oh, great.
Solid play, solid droning. Did you feel like really underpowered at any point during that game, or was it all cool?
It was fine. It was just like, it was fine. I think I was... maybe those you're on loco TV jitters.
it's fucking terrifying, man.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, I understand. It's weird when there's people watching you when you usually just play by yourself. But all right, let's have a quick look at the replay.
Okay.
Yeah, people in the chat are saying APM doesn't mean skill. That's definitely true, but it does help when you're fast if you like getting coached, you know? Some people I know are very efficient with like 50 APM, and that's fine. But it's easier for me to like talk about certain things during the game when I know for a fact it's going to be something you can follow up as well, and that's something you need to like process for like the next 2 minutes. But yeah, both work. I definitely do think like high APM is a little bit nicer, especially when you're getting coached. I would say 100 APM is doable for pretty much everyone, but all right, so besides just the build, there's obviously a couple more things to it. I was doing all scouting during this game with my secret minimap hacks and being the observer of the game. Basically, I didn't really do anything too fancy, to be honest. Basically, what I was really checking for is whether or not he was moving out. And that's like the main thing. So having a Zergling right there and maybe another Zergling right there and maybe even a Zergling at its watchtower would be basically telling you whenever he is moving across the map, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I feel like that is like one of the absolute main important things to just try and have as well in the game. So on this specific map, you can't take a watchtower to see if he's moving out. So just try and have like 100% of the time. Well, maybe not right there because it's easy for him to see as well. Maybe a little bit more back. But just just so you can know when he's moving out. The worst thing that could happen is that he all of a sudden pops up right there and he has 20 Marines and you're like, well, shit.
Yeah.
That's like the absolute worst. So just try and prevent that from happening at all times. That's true for every single map. Just have something close to his base, either something at the watchtower or an overlord overlooking a location or a zergling or whatever, just so you know if he's moving out.
Okay.
Yeah, so scouting with zerglings. Have a zergling at all times close to close to his base, and also have the watchtowers at all times.
Okay.
I think that's going to be the two things we're going to be working on for the next game. Just making sure you have a zergling close to his base at all times, and also have the watchtowers taken no matter what. I know watchtowers don't give you a heck of a lot on this map, but it's a good habit to just make sure you have the watchtowers no matter what. Like, if you're going to have the watchtower, he's not going to have it, and that already should be reason enough.
Right, and he might make a mistake and take his dropship too close to it or something. It might just give me...
Exactly. Yeah. Yeah. We can go over overlord scouting as well. I don't want to do, like, too many things at once.
Okay.
So, yeah, we can just play one quick game and then go over overlord scouting if you'd like.
All right.
Cool. That was good, though.
Thank you.
So, for the next one, we're going to... Oh, what the hell? Battle.net may be unavailable. Great. All right. My StarCraft 2 just locked me out. Great.
Oh, no.
Yeah, so for the next one, what we're going to be working on is just the exact same thing, except we're now going to be, well, working on these couple things I mentioned, and we want to have Zerglings out on the map at all times.
Okay. Are you loading up your StarCraft 2?
Yeah. I'm hoping it will lock me in.
Can I get water while you're doing that?
Yeah, of course. No problem.
Cool.
Yeah, so people are talking about spamming right now in the chat. Spamming hotkeys, I honestly would not recommend it. It is how I get my hotkey or my APM up way high. I used to have a solid 300 APM every single game. But most of that was completely wasted. And right now I have about 250 APM, 220 APM, depending how long the game goes. But especially in late game, I do use most of those actions. So if you're spamming and you're gonna be like, you know, wasting all of your APM on just purely spam, it's not gonna achieve anything. But I do agree that spamming is a pretty reasonable way to get your APM up, but not really that useful most of the time. But it's okay.
Am I getting bashed in the chat for my spam?
No, actually, it's just Doug.
It is Doug.
He said, Fred is a spammer hotkey guy. I tried spamming it, and I tell you, I calls all my workers to stop working. Yeah, exactly, like Doug is saying there in the chat. If you're spamming and your workers stop working, then you're doing it wrong. Like, if you're getting less done with more actions, you're doing it wrong.
That's right. Go get your spam in a can. You can't handle it.
Yeah, but I did think spamming is an alright way to get your APM up. As long as you actually transfer it to something useful as well. Like, if you're purely spamming all game long, you have 400 APM, but you're not doing anything, then it's obviously not worth it.
I feel like it just gets my hands ready for when I do need to multitask a lot.
Mm-hmm.
It keeps me like ready.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
He says, this is my life. I'm always doing it wrong. What? It's okay, dog. It's okay, man.
He's taking it down a dark path.
Yeah, it's got depressing really fast, man. All right.
No, Doug's probably one of the funniest people I've ever met in my entire life.
All right.
It's my best friend's older brother.
Cool.
Introduced me to the StarCraft back in 98, as he said.
Damn. Dude, I could barely walk when I was 90, like in 90. I wanted to buy the game, okay? There's actually like, I wanted to buy the game because I heard it was good. My mom wouldn't let me buy it because the guy at the front, I think it was Raynor or something, or Kerrigan or whatever it was, looked scary.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, oh, and then she let me like buy GTA and stuff instead, which is...
You're doing it wrong.
Yeah, it's like Warcraft 3, you know how the case has like this orc screaming on it? I really wanted to buy it because I heard the game was awesome, but mom didn't agree.
Oh, yeah. How old are you, Loco?
I'm 22 right now.
Okay. So
in 98, I was 6.
Yeah.
All right. So yeah, let's just focus on the same thing again and just make sure there's Zerglings out on the map. I'm going to try and talk a little bit less during this one, but obviously if you have any questions, let me know.
Word. Oh, what was the timing on that when you told me to gas up on my to get the double gas on in my main? Was that after my natural saturated?
Yeah, so what you do, you get the first gas is at 5 minutes, which should be 36 supply. And then once you start up the lair, you start a whole bunch of things. So when you start up the lair, you start up the Roach Warn, you start up the double Evos, and then you start up the double gas.
Okay, okay.
Or the double Evos, Roach Warn, and then the double gas. Somewhere around that time. Ideally, you would make them slightly later if you want to play it perfect, but I like grouping it up. So it's like lair, Evo Chambers, Roach Warn, gas.
Okay.
All of us mid-30-year-olds are watching this and feel bad. Well, it's okay, man.
I'm only 27. I'm not there yet. Like
no. Dog is, man. Dog, and that's what's up. Oh, man. Lord Jama says, I'm late 40s and I played Warcraft 2. Man.
I played Warcraft 2, though. Hell yeah. I loved clicking on the guys. Yes, you would. Stop poking me. I was like, this is awesome.
I have not played any of that. I probably should go around and do that.
Oh, Warcraft 2, I think Dark Tides. Tides of Darkness.
I played the Lost Vikings, the original Lost Vikings recently, and that was actually really, really good.
I've never even heard of that.
No, it's like the original title of like before they even made Warcraft and StarCraft and all that stuff.
Oh, wow, okay.
It's like 1994, I believe, or something. It's actually a really good game. Like, Blizzard knows how to make games. Alright, so we want to go 15 hatch, 15 pool. And then go up to 4 queens as fast as possible. And obviously, don't forget the Zerglings this time, because lurkers, or like, not lurkers, Reapers are annoying.
Yeah.
Yeah, so a normal overload here would be 17.
You wanted me to hit an overload before I hit 17, or?
No, 17 right now, yeah. Exactly like you're doing right here is like the ideal, or like the standard.
Okay, great.
So my production chap cheat is telling me that he's going Reaper again. So, you know, just to so you can mentally prepare. It doesn't matter, we should be making a counter to it anyway, but just so you are aware of it.
Okay.
Exactly. That's literally the only change, and that should cost you, like, no Zerkins anymore. So 4 Zerkins would be the max I would make. Okay, another queen. There we go. Okay. And then another overlord. Exactly.
Man, that 25 overlord, I consistently forget to make that. every game.
Well, make it a 20 then. Okay, if you always forget it, just make it earlier.
Yeah.
Oh, and a quick tip against microing against Reapers. Just try and never leave creep. Well, unless you can get a surround. Oh. Ooh. Alright, queen injects. Oh, he actually already did. Not bad. Yeah, see? This is the correct way of doing it. Alright, next overlords as well. And next queen. Oh, wow. That's nice of him.
That was very generous.
Yeah. That's actually huge for a Terran player. Like, losing that sucks. Okay, good. So we're about a good 20 seconds faster than last game. So if you feel like really threatened in ZVT, this would be a good time for a spine if you'd like to.
Okay. And actually, I need to scout him out.
And take the watchtowers, yeah. Cool. Okay, saturate the gases. Yeah, so right now we're a little bit, like, you have a lot of gas already, right? Or a lot of minerals already, so I'd rather, like, start to gas this up right around right now.
Okay.
And exactly like you're doing right now, the three queens for defense is good. Okay, and then Lair. So if that Zergling dies, right, at the bottom of his ramp, like, replace it immediately.
Sneaky.
Very good. Okay. Do you want to saturate the gases? Hit the other gases as well. And I think we only need a couple more drones in the main base and we're done. Good. Okay. Want to start +1/+1, and then a third base. Yeah. Good. So this is looking a lot more solid. Now keep in mind, we do want to scout at the bottom of that ramp because we still don't know what's going on over there.
Okay.
And also, if we can, want to try and take the watchtowers too. Oh.
No.
slow Zerkins can't do it. All right. So want to start a couple overlords? And replace those links again. Very good. Okay, now it's all gonna be about micro. Well, and overseers. He will never suspect a thing. Alright, just make a couple. You do need an overseer right now, though, because this is gonna be real annoying otherwise. It's fine. Yeah. Just make an overseer here. There we go. Yeah, roaches should be able to clean this up easily. Okay, big run of roaches. Okay, and make sure you hit the queen injects right now because it's going to be real important. We only have one queen right now.
Oh.
Okay, good. Okay, saturate the last gas as well. Very good. And don't forget the overseer on the other side of the map as well because you're going to need it. So okay. I would like make that overlord, like the first one you have, like make that into an overseer.
The first overlord I have.
Yeah, it's like right behind his natural. Or that one. Yeah, there we go. Just something so you have an overseer on his side of the map too. Okay, we're done. Let's go.
Okay.
Okay, you can make one more big round of drones, I think. Or one big round of roaches, sorry. Ooh. There we go. Yeah, that should have been there a little bit earlier, but... Okay. I'm gonna start the overlords. And let's get attacking. So if you feel like you're not gonna make this aggression, right, you need to start droning off the third base. So just be aggressive until you know for a fact that you won't be able to kill him. And then go for the...
Should I take out his third or go on his
lantern? We go for the third, yes. Well, kill that SCV real fast. Kill the SCV. Okay, good. Okay. Especially because you have so many roaches still incoming, right? Okay, go. So let's go for the natural. So I would start droning up the third base once you realize that you don't... Like, you can't kill him. But I don't know. Maybe you can't, but I'm just saying. Okay, let's go. Oh man, we sold him so well.
I did.
Yeah.
I didn't see that he had so many.
Yeah. Well, the correct way to do that would be to run up a couple roaches up the ramp and then just go up there and kill him.
Set him off. Yeah. I've never seen so many.
Yeah, it's really annoying actually. Once they get to this point, it's very difficult to take it. Actually, the correct approach to mass baneling would be mass.
Swarmos? Not Swarmos.
Actually, banelings. Interestingly enough. So I would probably, this is going to be kind of interesting. But yeah, just note that you could have won right there, okay? So whatever happens in the rest of this game, it all doesn't really matter too much. Because you're probably not going to die to that again. Lesson is learned the hard way. But yeah, just start up oh, you already got it, good. Just make a massive army, start up the 2-2. And yeah, so I would go for Roach Bane in this situation.
Okay. I don't know if I start up that 2-2 for you. Sorry.
Yep. Okay. And well, definitely also start Overseer speed. This is gonna be necessary. Oh nice. Oh man, you're using the map. Somewhere Dustin Browder is very happy right now. Okay, couple Zerglings. And the gas is at the third as well. Well, I maybe also start Zergling speed in this scenario, I suppose. If he's going this heavy into Widow Mines. And Baneling speed too. Okay, so walk a couple of roaches forward if you can find the time. Okay, there we go. That's it. Now you can go. Just attack me. Very good. Okay, clean him up. Ooh. That is not worth it for him. Alright. So morphing a couple of the Banes. So basically the idea is you get these Banelings on top of him, right? So you do want to try and get to the point where you have the Banelings. Or the Baneling speed. Okay, so the next timing attack we can go for is right when +2/+2 finishes.
Get back!
Ooh. Yeah, so we're gonna need more... Wow, he's happy with himself. You do want to make sure you start a couple more Overseers as well. And ideally, like, the easiest way to do this is to probably have one of the Overseers not hotkeyed, but actually, like, hanging on one of the roaches. So, like, make one Overseer and just right-click that on a roach, so that one, at the very least, will not go down. Exactly. Okay, couple more Overlords, and big run of army here. Need to start moving. Get these minerals and gas down. Well, we need a couple Overlords, yeah. Oh, well, free pickoffs. I'll take him. Alright, you can take it. You can take him. Oh, man, this is so dirty. Alright, big round of roaches. Let's go. Massive round of roaches. Oh! Oh, no! No, no need to manually detonate. No!
Oh, oh shit. I did that.
Oh, shit.
I got excited. What is this Spider-Mind aggression?
I know, man. I know. Oh yeah, you could have just attacked me with them. You got greedy, man.
I get so mad when they're not rolling.
Yep.
Okay.
Okay, we need some Zerglings as well, yeah. Yeah, so at this point it's going to be tough because he's going to have three bases up and running, and the cost efficiency of Widowmines is starting to pay off. Doug is cheering for you in the chat, man.
Thank you, Doug.
Okay. So focus on the macro only, okay? We need to get those minerals down. Either way, make like a couple macro hatcheries.
Oh,
if you
I can. I have a lot of minerals. Oh,
yes.
Okay. I'm not even looking.
It's fine. Spend what you can. Okay. Very good. That's worth it for you. Alright. So Queen of Jackson, get that money down. No matter what, we need to spend that money. Okay, make like four macro hatcheries if you need to. Okay, three is enough, I suppose. Can't fit anymore. Alright, there we go. Okay. Just make sure you hold Peter.
Squeeze it to make it fit.
Yep. He's gonna be like, what the hell? Alright. Yeah, so right now he is actually maxed out. Looks like he's gonna start dropping you. Oh wow. This is unfortunate, but I think you could have won at that point. What we can do is actually jump into the replay in a little bit and then just continue the game from the point where you were being attacked in the when you were attacking his natural, you know. We may just GG out of this one, to be honest, because it's just this sort of games will not happen again, I don't think.
Okay.
Yeah, let's just do one more massive attacks, yeah.
Okay, yeah, I just wanna...
There's no giving up now, right? Like.
I don't wanna give up to this guy.
I understand. Okay, let's go. Now we're gonna need more Banes, though. A whole bunch more.
Oh, I didn't mean to blow him up.
Ooh. Oh god. Oh god. I hate that sound, dude. Ba-da-da-dum. Okay.
Did he explode all those?
I don't think so.
He's got so many. I've never seen anything like this.
Yeah, it's a weird strategy. Oh my god, man. It's a weird strategy that that happens every now and then. It can be very powerful.
It's like he knew I was going for a Roach build.
I think you could have won, though. I think I'm pretty sure you could have won. But yeah. At this point he's still maxed out, dude, so it's gonna be near impossible. Alright. Let's have a quick look at the replay. Dude, my StarCraft 2 crashed again.
Oh, mine did.
I got a notice that the achievements were disabled, and then it stopped working. It's like, nope, no more StarCraft guys.
Yeah, when we were attacking, I honestly have never seen that many spider mines in my life.
Yeah.
So I would normally, oh, there's a spider mine, I'd back out and I'd run a few lings in, or in this case I had roaches,
yeah.
Let them go off and then come in and take them out.
Yeah, exactly. Like that would be the correct approach. Just walk a couple of roaches up there, detonate all these guys. They will die for the greater grit, man. Like it will be worth it.
I don't know why it's not letting me log in.
Yeah, I had to close the game and then restart it again.
Okay, that might be my situation as well. What's really going on?
Yeah, so the only way that I have personally found to like deal with Mass Widowmine, I thought it was like Swarm Host or something like that as well, but it really doesn't. Well, the current Swarm Host definitely don't work. The easiest way of dealing with it is just trying to engage on creep and then rolling Banelings into the Widowmines. It's the weirdest thing ever, but they blow themselves up, and at that point, like, there's very little Terran to actually deal with. But yeah.
And I probably shouldn't have manually detonated my Banelings at that point.
Yeah, yeah. Just attack move with them and they will blow themselves up on those units. Or at least, I think they do. I mean, I've played against this spell like 3-4 times. But yeah, just try and get Yeah, just try and like at least like detonate a couple of them instead of like all of them. Do you manage or did you manage to get in the game again?
It's loading up right now, sir. What's that?
Oh, all right. For whatever reason, your microphone got really loud for a second, but then Skype fixed it. Anyway. Skype is kind of awkward sometimes.
Yeah.
Yeah, other people in the chat are saying it as well. The guy that you were playing just now actually shows offline in-game, but he's actually just talking in the chat, so I'm not sure.
Alright, I am back in. I'll jump in the channel.
Cool. I don't know if I can invite him again. He seems to be offline.
Okay, well maybe we got someone else.
Yeah, if anyone else wants to play, feel free to join Group Loco TV on the North American server. Ideally, like a gold/platinum level Terran would be great.
Platinum would be great. Give me a whooping. Give me the most out of this coaching session. Come on.
Yeah, let's do it. Okay, platinum level Terrans, guys. Let's go. Group Loco TV on NA. It would be awesome. Could you grab me or toss me the party lead real quick?
Yes.
I just want to do that final engagement once again, or not the final engagement, but the engagement once again, just to see if you could actually, like, micro that one a little bit differently right now.
Okay.
I'll just take the Terran pieces for, like, a second. Alright, okay. So what we haven't really talked about yet is Overlord scouting and, like, transitions toward the mid-game after this, okay? I'm sure you can figure this build out perfectly in... you know, a couple more attempts or just, you know, a couple more games.
Yeah.
And I think, like, if you manage to nail it, I think you'll have a much easier time than Mutaling Bane. So I would just try it out for a while and see whether or not you like it. It should be good, though. But yeah, how do you think of it right now, though? Do you feel like it's a strong build or do you rather play Mutaling
Bane? Yeah, I do feel like it's a strong build. And I'm questioning why I got away from it in the past because... Mm-hmm. I did. This is how I got into Gold League, using a very similar build. And I think maybe it was my engagements with Protoss. And I was like, I can't win against Protoss, and I just quit. And then I guess I thought that I saw everybody else was doing Mutaling Bane, so I thought that there was a weakness for Roach against Bio. Obviously, if he has Marauders and Medivacs, that's not like the best matchup for me. But if I have Hydra's back in it, that's okay.
Yeah.
So in that situation, say that I engage him with those roaches, I see, oh, he scouted that, he knew what I was doing, he has Marauders, Medivacs. I would back up, play a little defense, take a third, get into Hydras, and then come back at him with Hydras?
Exactly, yes. So basically, okay. You would like, yeah, your main strength with Roach Hydra is when you attack with the upgrades finishing up, right? So right when +1/+1 finishes up, you're like you're significantly stronger than you were before that. And the same goes for +2/+2 and +3/+3 as well. So you want to try and line up like your attack moves right when those upgrades finish up.
Okay.
And that's true for every single matchup, by the way. That's not just EVT. Just always try and move out when upgrades finish. It's like the easiest way of like doing timing attacks, I suppose. It's a really easy fix, I guess. But it will make attacking a lot easier. And roaches, especially like benefit a lot from upgrades because you can line up the Glyo Reconstitution as well, right?
Mm-hmm.
So the 2-2 transition would either be like mass roach once again, or you can start adding on Hydralisk as well. If you do add Hydralisk, do make sure to get both of the upgrades. Like, don't just get ranged or just like speed. You're gonna need both of the Hydralisk, yeah, both of the upgrades. Okay. And then like your late game transition with this build would either be Broodlords, pretty much the same unit. Oh. But different.
Yeah, I mixed that. Yeah.
But the easiest one to do is probably Vipers. I don't know if you ever play with Vipers on like separate hotkeys and all that, but
you have to if you want to beat the Protoss Death Ball. So I played with it, Roach Hydra, get the Viper, have the Viper follow a Hydra, and then abduct the Colossi, in this situation, I would be using the Blinding Cloud more.
Exactly. Yeah, yeah. So, the thing with +3/+3, like, Roach Hydra is that it kills shit really fast. So if they take, like, a one-on-one engagement with you, if you manage to Blinding Cloud them and, like, leave the army, like, walking around for, like, a good 3 seconds or something, you will be able to already kill that army. But at that point, like, especially when... That's just one thing to realize about playing Roach Hydra. Once they get 3-3 out, it's very, very difficult to win. That's the only main weakness that I have found about this. But anyways, let's just take quick control of this replay. So look real quickly what he is having right now, right? He basically doesn't have shit.
No, he doesn't. He has spider mines.
Exactly. Yeah. So let's just play like 1 minute of this once again. And I'll just take control of Terran, and you can play the Zerg guy. Here we go. You ready? I hope you are.
Yeah.
So just run like a couple of the things up. I don't even know the hotkeys, man, for burrowing these things. Ooh, don't want to lose the Overseer, obviously.
Yeah, that happened. But luckily, Loco told me to build one over here on the side, so he's ready.
Alright, you're kind of on a timer, though, because obviously those things are gonna, like, shoot again very shortly. Oh, that actually sucks. I didn't think that about that. Dude, he's making so many Widow Mines. Well, actually, this may be very cost-efficient in the end. Yeah, I think it's going a little bit too slow, because right now I'm gonna have to cool down back again.
No!
Man, Widow Mines are good. Yeah, so that's just gonna be a matter of practice, but either way. Just to show you that, you know, running up all the roaches on the ramp is not gonna be
definitely.
Another option, what you could have obviously done, is just drone the fuck out of that third base and start adding on Hydras as well and Banelings and stuff.
Yeah.
That would have been another option right here, and not finish him off. But that would probably, actually, now I think about it, probably would be your best option to go for a heck of a lot of drones.
And he looked like he was pretty vulnerable in the back to a Nidus. I could have probably Nidus to get around that.
Yeah, for sure.
Maybe had Burrow on the Roaches.
Yeah. What I would probably try and do is move up a whole lot of, like, a couple Roaches and just run them up that ramp. And then once they're there, run a couple more and then start attack moving with the entire army. It's basically what you did, but then a whole lot faster. So basically, you send one Roach, you wait 2 seconds, and then you send another Roach up there. Just to have, like, those detonations done and then move up the ramp and kill all of those Widow Mines. But yeah, that's just, you know, you likely won't see that again on ladder. Now, it looks like there's actually no Platinum League Terrans tuned in, interestingly enough. Makarov says I can play Terran. You're Silver League right now, dude. Let's not. The Master League? Is that a Terran player? Guys, there must be a Platinum level Terran player tuned in right now. I can't imagine there isn't. Any gold? Terrence. Yeah, so the transition, once again, would be for 2-2, and then Hydralisk added on as well. And then the late game transition would be two Vipers, exactly like you were saying right there. And that would be basically like your game plan. And then if it goes like super late game, adding on Broodlords is like the best way to do it.
Okay.
Platinum level Korea.
Wraith Dagger is platinum.
Alright, he says I'm platinum level, but my Terran is fucked.
Oh, did he say that?
Yeah, he did say that, but generally speaking, if you're platinum random, you're also going to be platinum Terran easily.
Yeah.
Not to bash on Terran or anything, but... let's just go for a different map. Let's go Echo. I like Echo. One key thing though, because we may not see it, but one key thing with Vipers is that you really do need them on a separate hotkey group. Like having them on the same hotkey group is like the worst thing that could happen.
Exactly. Just as you were saying with the overlords, I didn't really think about doing that with the overseers, but that's probably the best move is just having them follow somebody in the back.
Yeah. So I have a couple on a hotkey, like maybe two or so, and I like two just hugging individual roaches. And you know, like not hotkeying and not hitting the select all army hotkey is your best friend there.
Mm-hmm.
Or maybe even like a separate hotkey for an overseer. If you're up against, like, I don't think you will see that again, you know, like Mass Widowmine is so uncommon, but if you happen to do see that again, you at least like have a better idea of how to go.
Yeah.
Alright, I think we have time for one more game right now. Yeah. Time always goes by so quickly. Do you have any questions before we jump into this one?
No, I'm feeling pretty good.
Alright.
I do have the question though. Sure. You were saying about the Hydra transition. I'm sorry, I didn't catch that. I go out, do my timing attack. If my timing attack doesn't take, what is the situation there? How much damage am I looking to do if I'm not going to win the game right then and there? And then do I keep roaching or do I keep droning? Go back to droning.
All right, yeah. So the reason why I usually don't make Hydras on two bases is because they cost too much gas. You really are going to need at least like 5 or 6 gas for it.
Right.
So what I would do is, like, the minimum amount of damage you're really looking for with this is to deny his third base, either by killing it or just killing a whole bunch of workers. And if you can, finish off the game, obviously. But the minimum amount of damage would be killing that third base. With that, you can drone up your own third base really aggressively. So usually what happens is you make, like, one big, big round of roaches and you realize, okay, I'm likely not going to be able to kill him. Then you drone up the third base completely. Like, you don't want to wait for a second right there. You want to start up +2/+2. You want to start up the Hydra then, and then you want to drone up that third base very aggressively until you have, like, you know, 25 workers there or something in total.
Okay.
Get the gases over there, obviously, and then start upgrading the Hydralisk. So what would happen is basically you're going to be left with, like, 65 or 70-ish drones, whereas he's going to be on two bases with, like, 40 or 50.
And when do I move out again?
When 2-2 finishes.
And I should have enough Hydras at that point.
Yes. You should have... No, basically, if you play like Roach Hydra, you want to have maybe 2/3 to 3/4 of Roach and then a couple Hydras in there as well. Don't like go overboard in Hydras.
Just dealing that damage to the back. Okay.
It's probably the easiest thing to keep in mind. Like... Yeah, like, reinforcing with Hydras is super scary, because they die so quickly, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's basically it.
Okay.
Alright, let's hope he's ready. Well, he'll likely mute the stream. If you haven't Raid Dagger, looking at you, man, could you mute it? That'd be great. Okay, let's go. Play Protoss and build pylons with BP. Well, that used to be a thing in Brood War. People would have to hit P for making a pylon. It's the worst fucking thing in the world. Brood War Protoss is actually used to, like...
This grid is fantastic.
Yeah. Like, Brood War Protoss is actually used to, like, bind their Nexus to 0. And, like, basically work on the right-hand side of the keyboard.
Oh, wow.
It's really confusing. Yeah, they have, like, 0, 9, and then, you know, eventually they would get down to, like... proper army hotkeys, but right now they moved it to E. You can actually still go to the default hotkeys, I believe, like the original ones, but it's a mess. Default in StarCraft 2 is E for pylon, yeah. Yeah, so someone in the chat is asking, 50-50 Roach Hydra isn't that great, maybe 65% Roach. Exactly, you'd want to have more Roach than you have Hydras. Having too many, like, the thing is, because your roaches should be in the front, they're gonna die first as well. And if you are left over with, like, a massive Hydra ball, they just die. Like, Hydras, they just die no matter what. So you don't want to have your Hydralisk exposed. So half Roach, half Hydra is a little bit too scary, I think. Yeah, I do use grid hold keys. It's just a little bit easier for me, but... It's just whatever you're used to. It really doesn't make a big, like, it doesn't make a big difference. It's not gonna be your, like, your platinum when you change your whole piece or whatever.
For the overloads on this one, I want to put one behind his natural and one behind that third that's across from the natural.
Yes, exactly. And for the Zergling positioning, it would be the exact same as, like, on the previous map.
Okay.
So just, like, something you can scout with. One really important thing as well is that you have something scouting his third base, okay? And on this map, it turns out that's the overlord behind the natural, or behind the main base, rather, that allows you to scout whether or not it takes a third. But definitely try and keep that in mind as well, so your roaches aren't gonna waste time, you know? Like, if you're gonna have to poke in and see, hey, is there a third base? That's like a wasted 5 seconds. And, you know, we're all about the 5 seconds here. Optimizing it.
It's time for him to put 45 more spider mines down.
Yeah. We'll see. This guy is going to be platinum.
I'm a little salty about spider mines. I really am.
They're a little bit annoying sometimes.
Oh, they're brutal.
Very good. Queen Arenos. And an Overlord. Don't forget it.
Oh man, I would.
I need another queen though. Do you have your health bars off? Or... We missed one queen in the main base. There we go. Are you playing with health bars off or no?
Yeah.
You might want to turn them on. It makes it easier to spoil whether or not you build them.
Okay. Oh, I forgot that Overlord, that Reaper.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I think that would actually be a massive change, dude. Putting on health bars on your units is going to be kind of confusing at first. But I noticed it in the couple games that we saw right now as well. You basically, like, sometimes miss creating a queen. Because you don't see, like, the bar that's producing it, right? Unless you mouse over.
Yeah, when my mouse is over it, I can see it.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, let's try and figure that one out. We can go over that after this one.
Do you want to pause it?
Yeah, we can actually pause it as well. Let's just pause it.
Okay.
It's gonna be really confusing at first, though. I'm not gonna lie.
Okay, not a big deal.
I actually can't pause the game because I didn't set myself the referee.
Okay.
I'm an idiot.
I can do that.
Alright, if you go to F10 options gameplay, there is show unit life bars. Try and set that. I believe a lot of people like damaged, but I would recommend putting it to always, unless you really cannot handle it.
Display team colored life bar?
No, it's show unit life bars. Do you see that one?
I guess I gotta read it all.
It's like if you go to options and then gameplay, it is right underneath like menu screen background and above show flyer help. Do you see it?
I don't know why I don't.
It should say.
Oh, I'm sorry. I do see show unit life bars. I'm looking at the other ones I have to check. Show unit life bars. Do I want targeting selected, damaged, always?
Yeah. The easiest one to learn, I suppose, would be damaged. But I prefer always. Like, it really is up to you. Most of the players do play with always on.
Okay, and will that show, like, when my queens are building and things like
yes,
that?
Yes, yes. You will see life bars everywhere, though. It's gonna, like, be really confusing, I think, but...
Okay.
That's actually a pretty big change right there. Should make it a lot easier to see if, like, things are building and stuff. It's the same with the upgrades. Like, for the longest time in the last game, you were looking at the Evo Chambers, but didn't notice that the plus one armor wasn't building. Okay, so if you make something right now, like, let's make two more queens, we can see what happens.
Oh, yeah, look, it shows me when I need a queen inject. That's amazing.
All right, man, we found your fix to diamond. Like, all right, let's start up the lair, though, because we're completely off of the build right now. Do you want to restart it, or...?
No, I can handle it.
All right.
If you want me to, I can.
Yeah, let's just restart it really quickly. It's probably gonna be easier. Just so you can get used to this one as well. Let's just restart it really quick. Because right now things are a little bit messed up, you know. It's gonna be a massive change, though. I don't know if you're like.
Loco, I know that we're on the time limit here. Do you care if I run to the bathroom real quick? Is that all right?
No, that's fine, dude.
Alright, cool. Thanks.
Yeah, life bars are massive. Life bars are very, very important. Someone in chat is asking, do Lynx counter stalkers? In reasonable numbers, yes. If it's gonna be like a massive like 8-gate all-in with Stalker Blink or whatever, you're gonna need Hydras or Roach Ling or something. But Zerklings are amazing against them. Either that or you upgrade your Zerklings, go with +1/+1. Zerklings are great if you have +1/+1 versus Blink Stalkers, but. Unless Blink Stalkers, then Lynx are useless. Well, not useless, but it's still gonna be better to add some Hydras in there. Basically, if you're not sure how to counter gateway units, Hydra Ling or Roach Ling is your go-to thing. Seriously, like Hydra Ling literally counters everything with gateway. Alright, man. Oh, I should probably move things around.
You have to do 3 coaching sessions today?
No. I'm doing 3 a week right now.
Oh, okay.
I used to do multiple a day.
Oh, this is the first of 3 for the week, I guess?
Yeah, this is actually the first of 3 for a week. Yeah, I actually wrote down, because we're going to do 3 in total as well. You may be mentioning that. But.
Okay. I thought you said you were doing 3 today. I'm like, that's intense, man. You are...
I used to do multiple a day, but it sucks. Like, it's no fun anymore after a while, you know? I really, really enjoy doing it if it's like 3-4 times a week at max. But if it gets any more than that, it just starts feeling like work, and that's not cool.
No, who wants to work?
Oh, man, fuck that. I want to play video games.
Like, my job, man, I take people around to show them how to eat Vietnamese street food. Like, I take them, like, super, super local places. But as part owner of the company, if you want to go on a tour with me, it's really expensive. Mm-hmm. And as I'm a chef as well, so we call it the chef's tour. And unfortunately, I've been getting like rich people that come out on the tour, and they're not foodies at all. They were just buying my most expensive thing, which makes it really not fun for me anymore, because it's supposed to be like for real, real foodies, you know?
Yeah. Like people that actually really care, and then there's just these rich people that like, you know, have a couple hundred to blow on nothing.
They'll come out to get on the motorbike and they're wearing like jewelry and high heels. And I'm like, you have to go change. Somebody's going to steal that. Like, you high right now?
Like, that sounds like a pretty cool job, though. You mentioned it in the chat the other day as well. I think that's pretty cool. Cool sounding job.
It's an awesome job. It really is. And I don't even, I'm owner of the company. I really, I look over the company for the most part. And then I do my chef tours, and sometimes I come out on our big tours.
That's awesome, dude.
Yeah.
How many people are working for you?
I have over 30.
That's true. That's cool. That's really, really good. And yeah. US based or Taiwanese based then? Or.
No, we're Vietnamese based.
Oh,
we're
wait, Vietnamese. Sorry, yeah.
We own the company. Me, my friend, and his wife. She's Vietnamese. Cool. He's American.
That's really cool, dude.
Yeah. That's a lot They're of opening actually. A restaurant right now in Philadelphia. Yeah, it's awesome. A lot of people, and all, like, really cute Vietnamese girls, so I'm, like, the luckiest man on the planet.
So you're basically just serving Vietnamese food, or, like, you know, taking rich people on Vietnamese food trips?
Yeah, right.
Cool.
Now, sometimes they take out, like, real, like, foodies, like, real chefs, and that's a really cool experience. They're really curious, because it's a very different style of food here.
Yeah. No, I have no idea. I just know... We just got probably the racist Vietnamese food over in the Netherlands, like, like the typical Asian stuff with like hot sauce and like, you know, it's really quite bad. I don't think that's anything to do with Vietnamese food at all, but. Cool. That's nice though. Is that a good place to live though? Vietnam?
I love it here, man. I love it. It's great weather. It's very, very affordable. So, you know, before living in America, it was very paycheck to paycheck situations for young people.
Mm-hmm.
And I got to move here, and you work hard, and you come up with a good idea, you could really do well.
Cool. Yeah, I like the sound of that, though. That's cool.
Yeah, Asia's awesome.
Yeah, I know a couple people that do basically like online work, basically what I do pretty much, I suppose, but they like basically work for like a Dutch salary or like a European or, you know, American salary, but they actually live in Vietnam or like, you know, any of those cheaper countries, and obviously you can live there like, you know, super rich because you're working for a completely different salary.
Exactly.
That's cool.
Alright, we're making the Overlord. He's destroying my city.
We're forgetting the Overlord again. Okay. There we go. Cool. Just leave these Zerglings up there. Up there, ramp is fine. There we go. Okay, we'll start with the other queens. And maybe even a spine crawler. Let's go for a spine crawler this time. We're flooding minerals anyway, we may as well.
Okay,
want to start up the double gas too?
I'm a little behind on the build, sorry there.
Yeah, that's fine though.
It's that one Reaper could really throw you off your game.
I know.
If you're a novice like myself.
Nah, dude. You're not a novice. Alright, keep the droning up. Very good. Put the drones in the gas. And want to make two more overlords. So right now is a good time to start producing double overlords instead of single ones. Just a good habit.
I like this. This guy's working me.
Yeah. Yeah, this is Platinum League, right? Like, there's a difference. He's not going to lose that to slow Zerglings. Make the overlords, by the way, because we're going to hit this supply loop soon.
There we go. I think I have two popping up, maybe.
Nope. Okay, want to start up the lair? And then the Evo Chamber. Oh, well, there we go. Or Evo Chamber's on the lair. It works.
Oh, it is Evo Chamber first, right? Sorry.
Yeah, usually you would start the lair and then the Evo Chamber's around the same time. This is pretty much the same. Alright, I would re-rally the main to the main and then start the double gas. Dude, the Terran music is playing in the background right now. It's so good.
Okay. So, Marines, he's building a bunker in front.
Okay. Big round of drones. When you have your scouting like this, just keep max running behind it. Exactly. Okay, wanna start +1/+1? So whenever you're like running up a Zergling, there's a reason to look at the Zergling, but no reason to macro or to not macro at the same time. Okay, very good. Very good, well spotted. Put the drones in the gas. So we are a little bit slow on the droning this time around. Okay, wanna start +1 armor and roach speed. Okay, and now a couple overlords, and then we can start the roach production. Okay, I like the execution here, that's good. I like that you have a Zergling at the front, I like that you're having, well, almost control of the watchtower, but that's no big deal. But you'd at least, like, know what's going on right now, you know?
Yeah.
If you really wouldn't be sure, you can also make sure you actually fly in an overlord. It is not absolutely necessary with this build.
He's coming in with the...
Yeah, you can start making the roaches, just make the roaches. We were going for those anyway. Big group of them. There we go, good. Okay, so make non-stop roaches right now. Try and keep your minerals as low as possible, okay? You don't really want to go over like 300 at all. There's no reason to. Just make overlords and roaches, overlords and roaches. And should be able to... Yeah, just nail it. So we can like attack with a maximum amount of army as well instead of like 20 roaches following it up, you know? Okay, just move them down right here. Don't let the crew spread die. No reason to. There we go. Like, fuck off, Terran.
Oh, what's really going on?
Dead Reaver came back in, man. The second round. All right. Okay, so it's time for us to start attack moving across the map. Let's go. And I'm behind it. Okay. Make the third base. Exactly. Good job. Okay. Okay, I would already start +2/+2 right now, if you can. But keep moving. Don't slow down. Don't slow down. Okay, nice. Couple overlords. And he's likely gonna lift this one off. But yeah, just try and force the lift off and I go straight for the natural.
Oh, I'm gonna get some mules.
Yeah, that's nice. That's like 1,000 minerals right there. Alright, and for the natural. Let's go. Don't want to delay. Okay, couple. Are you already dead? Good. Oh, let's move. Okay, move up a little bit. There we go. Good. Okay, and Queen and Jack's at home. There's nothing to see here. There's nothing to see. Okay, good. I'm gonna start +2/+2 and Hydras. Oh, nice.
Is moving in like that a good move, or I shouldn't have done that?
Yeah, that's good. As long as all your roaches are firing, that's good. Okay, so right now it looks like you may be able to deal some damage, but it's also a pretty reasonable time to start droning up again. So I would re-rally the bases to the third, and then start making drones. And also start up the Hydra then. So this is looking very, very good right here, dude. This is really, really good play.
I got a Grandmaster talking in my ears.
Well, but I mean, you're the one executing this. I'm not actually doing all that much. I'm just saying, like, you know, I'm just doing some of the harder thinking for you. But, you know, it's just... Mechanically is what the most difficult part is, and yeah.
Oh, nope, that queen's gonna run over there. Nope, stay it's where fine, you belong. Oh, I have to one, awesome.
Okay, big round of drones, and then the upgrades. Yeah, so don't sacrifice the army, obviously. Don't sacrifice the roaches.
Oh.
Just send them back home, yeah.
I had them all, Oh, that did some damage, that was nice.
Yeah, so he actually held that reasonably well, though. There was, he's still actually a little bit ahead in supply right now, which is annoying. But it's just showing you, you know, how to follow it up with. It's very good. Okay, so I want to start a big round of Hydras next. And then move out again when +2/+2 finishes, okay? Okay, you do need the gases at the 13 a little bit, too. And I would probably just queue up the other upgrade for the Hydras.
Would I make another Zergling, a batch of Zerglings here and send them out to keep scouts?
Yes.
Or
yes, definitely. Okay, make sure you start the second Hydra upgrade. In the Hydra den. And we do need a couple more workers there, though. Else you're gonna flood gas hard. So I will make like 10 more workers or something and then move across the map. Well, there we go. You should be able to clean that up. So whenever there's a drop like this, okay? Whenever there's a drop like this, automatically split up your army. There's no way he's not gonna do a double drop, especially in Platinum League. I don't know if he is. I actually don't know. Maybe he is doing only a single drop. But you gotta like start assuming that he's gonna do double drops, okay?
Okay.
So if you think like a Terran right now, you would basically say, alright, he would probably go for the main base and the third base. Like, having an entire army defend one drop is really not necessary.
In this situation, I lost a lot of drones. Do you want me to build more drones or build more Hydras right now with less money?
I would move out right now and then make a group of roaches, or a group of drones for the third, yes.
Okay.
And then start decking up towards the Hive. Yeah, so maybe wait for these 11 Hydras and then, well, move. Okay.
I see you! Oh, no.
That's fine. Hydras are good. Okay. Let's get the money down. It's starting to flood again. Okay, Queen injects. And let's get moving. Very good. Okay, and this is also when you would start decking up towards the Hive. But definitely keep moving. Like, I think there's a little bit too much of a delay here. Well, unless it's...
Can I take that?
I'm pretty sure you can. Not if you give him too much time, no?
Okay.
Yeah, he just finished up 2-2, so maybe a little bit too much now. Yeah, sorry, that's mainly my bad.
Well, I was moving slow too.
Well, you're still gonna be able to clear. I guess I was right.
All right. Should I go into his third or?
No, I would probably send this home because, well, you can. Maybe you can actually do some damage, I suppose. Yeah, it's a reinforcement that's not coming in. Yeah.
That was death. Yeah.
Alright, so usually we want to start tacking up to a hive a little bit faster. And also, taking a fourth base behind it would be a very good option.
Should I finish saturating this third?
Yeah. Yep. You're still actually ahead in supply, though, so it's looking nice.
So this is a situation where I'm building up a lot of money. I should probably build a couple macros.
Exactly, yes. So maybe you even want to consider going for some infestors or something like that with this army composition. But you have this much gas, it may be worth your time to add like a couple of infestors with the army.
Okay.
If you notice you're like flooding a lot of gas, that's like a good option. Same for Vipers and stuff. You can never really go wrong with it, you know, as long as you're using the unit, I suppose. Alright. So once again, drops in the main base. Let's get some army over there. Okay, we'll want to start up the hive. Well, target fire down the dropship. Very, very well done. Good. Alright, well, he's moving in though, so... Well, don't donate the army, yeah. Big round of roaches here. Oof. There's 22 roaches. Alright. Yeah, and I would definitely add on some infestors here, just for the fact that you can make them. There's really no reason not to have like 5,000 guests or like 1,000.
If I'm doing infestors, put them on a separate hotkey like I just did too.
Yes, exactly.
And do I need to research burrow?
It would be a pretty good upgrade right now. It's not the biggest of deals. If you plan on using it, definitely do. Alright, so we do want to start moving
macro,
very soon.
When you get macro hatches going like this, is it important to build queens each time that you do this?
Not if you have like queen energy like this. If you're playing Roach Hydra, you don't need as many larvae anyway.
So what do you think the move here is? My thing is to go around and try to attack his third, I guess?
Yeah, exactly. I would try and make sure he doesn't take a fourth. Well, what's this? Okay, big round of Roach Hydra here. Keep making army. Very, very good. Oh, don't quite have a fungal ready, but looking very nice. No, just keep moving. Just keep following right now, yeah. The reinforcing Roach Hydra can definitely... I would reinforce with roaches mainly, by the way. Hydra reinforcements are scary. Okay, fungal.
I'm gonna give me some dropships.
Fungal.
It is. I said it to fungal.
Oh yeah, you don't actually have to shift Q fungals. You can just. Oh well, we're gonna have to move around here. You can actually just without shift Q, just attack. May want to knock down the rocks at his third base. Or well, if you can take out a base, you may obviously take out the base as well. Yeah, this is platinum macro. I don't think this guy is even platinum league, dude. He's macroing really fucking good. Alright, he's not even flooding 200 minerals, like... Alright. Wanna start up +3/+3? +3/+3 and a couple Vipers if you can. Okay, well, let's keep attacking.
Okay.
Oh, sent these guys over to the fourth. There we go. Oh, well, that's
the non-existent one. Destroyed, yeah.
Alright, yeah, there's definitely a lot of delay right here, right? We want to try and, like, minimize that. Okay. Let's go up that ramp.
Okay.
Okay, move the army. Yeah, there we go. Very nice. So, notice, though, your reinforcements are walking into his army. You donated the reinforcement just now.
Oh, man.
Yeah, that's just a matter of practice on this map. Yeah, you may be, yeah, that was a big chunk of army just wasted right there. Alright. So if you want to beat this, we're gonna need Vipers, okay? You're gonna have to make a couple Vipers right here. I would probably just make like three of them and then wait for them to come out and max out on an army again. I don't think you can take this fight right now without them. Okay, there we go. And a big round of Roach Hydra. Try and max out on this before the next fight. That macro. Good. Oh, man. Is there something burrowed there? No, there isn't. Alright. So make sure the Vipers are on a separate hotkey. I don't know, they are no, they are not currently.
They are not, no. Sorry.
That's okay. We're gonna need them here. Oh, look at the army.
No! It's so brutal.
Yeah. That's unfortunate.
Yeah. You know, it's alright. This is what I wanted to work on, you know.
Yeah, there's no way a Gold League player would have won against this, to be fair. Like, his macro is very solid. Like, even right now, he's not flooding even 200 minerals. He is flooding a whole bunch of gas, though, but... Yeah, like, once Terran is in this position, it's like... You know, it's like, game over, pretty much.
Yeah.
But, yeah, well done. Very, very well done. That was actually very solid.
Thank you.
Lesson learned, I suppose.
Yeah. You want me to exit out, right?
Yeah, let's just exit out of it.
Okay.
That's pretty good, man. That's very, very nice.
Thank you. It was, there was a point when I ran my backup army into mm-hmm. his army.
Yeah.
I was trying to build more units, and when I clicked my hotkey, I accidentally put all of my queens with my hatcheries, so then it wouldn't let me build, so it kind of messed me up. And I know I do that a lot, where when it gets in like the heat of the moment, I have mm-hmm. to do a lot of stuff. Sometimes I hit the wrong keys, and I definitely make mistakes.
Yeah, that happens to everyone, though. That's not really that big of a deal. It actually coincidentally also was the same point where he finished up these 3-3 upgrades. Or actually, I think he did that slightly before that, but it makes his army like a lot stronger. Usually like when +3/+3 finishes for marine bio stuff, Roach Hydra just sort of falls off. Even if you have like really, really good blinding clouds, it's still very difficult. But without blinding cloud at that point, it's going to be very, very hard.
Right.
So that's sort of the moment I was talking about right there, where... You know, you can see how much damage you, or how much damage Terran army really will start doing. That just happens over, like, a lot of time, though.
In situations like that, if you know that you're getting deep into the game, and if you could spare the actions per minute, I guess floating a couple overlords in and doing contaminate on his engineering bay would kind of mess him up a little bit.
Yeah, for sure.
Just some more time.
Yeah, and also, like, I think the main thing, though, is having the Vipers and the +3/+3 a little bit earlier right there. I think that's mainly just the lack of practice, because you were at Hive for a little while, but then we weren't actually using any of the Hive things. And that's totally fine. It doesn't oftentimes go to these kind of games, right? Like, most games are decided by, like, the 15-minute mark. Yeah. I don't know, actually, what exact league he is. He may be, like, Platinum on EU or something.
Yeah. Okay, I guess, I guess my whole point is that I'm trying to reach up to the Platinum level, and there's always going to be that, okay, you should change your build order a bit, you should do this a bit. Are there any, like, key pieces that I really need to focus on during my game that I'm missing? Like, I guess the Zerg scouting is probably a big deal.
Mm-hmm. I think the main important one is that sometimes you have the tendency to, like, float, like, 1,000 to 2,000 minerals, even though you have larva available. It's not even, like, the queen injects most of the time, it's just that there's, like, a whole bunch of bank just sitting there. Even though you have larva, and even though you're having your queen injects done, the spending of it seems a little bit on the lower priority. So really what you want to be focusing on always is like having your queen injects done, and then having your spending done right afterwards. And that also
queen
makes like its whole like
money.
Yeah, like queen injects spend the money, and then that also like makes the overlord issue that you were having for a little bit easier, because you will just hit the queen inject, you will look at the amount of supply you have, make a couple overlords, and then spend the minerals that you have. So it's like a different pattern, I suppose. So you focus queen injects, spending. Queen injects, spending.
Okay.
Yeah, and obviously, like, especially in the first games we saw, that maybe just because, you know, I'm watching the game and you have a live stream and stuff. But there was also like just points where you just slipped on the queen and jacks completely, and that's just, yes, you know, that's just pretty much game ending.
Yeah.
But that's just, you know, it happens every now and then, and then there's not that much else to really do about it, I suppose. Just a matter of focus.
Do you feel like that happened a lot, like in this last game?
No, this last game was really good.
Okay.
This last game was platinum level, easy play. Like, I don't know. I'll ask Freight Dagger. Freight Dagger, do you play mainly EU? Because he played really, really well right here, actually. He didn't float minerals at any point. Like, he was like 300 minerals, the highest I've seen him, I think. And that's when he made like a command center.
Wow.
His macro was really solid. But anyways, yeah, so definitely try and focus on this build some. And then, yeah, you got me on Skype, so just let me know if you have any questions or any replays you really want me to take a look at.
Okay.
And I'll just like look at those as soon as possible.
Okay.
We do still have two other coaching lessons to do as well, right?
Yeah, right. And so in between that, I guess the next time that we do a coaching session, I'll change that priority list. And I think that's going to be a priority list. Make sure I'm getting the scouting done and then just keep doing what I'm doing on the other end. I guess it'll come.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. And just like if you have questions, just let me know, you know, because I did make a bunch of notes, but I didn't actually write down too much.
Okay.
But yeah, if you have anything that you're wondering about, just let me know. And, you know, I'll just enter it as soon as possible. We seem to be online around the same time zone somehow.
It's because I keep weird hours. Are you're going to email me this notepad, this list that I guess that you made, or?
Yeah. Do you use Evernote by any chance?
I do not.
All right. Yeah. I'll just send it to you. I can just, do you have Word or something or like Google Docs?
You could copy and paste and put an email.
Yeah. That works as well. I'll just do that right away. It's probably easiest. All right. Cool, man. So yeah, just let me know when you would like to do the next coaching. I would do like a week or so in between.
Okay.
Although I am really like kind of busy right now, but.
Okay, why don't you look at your dates when you get a chance? I know you're taking a trip to Scotland, and then you're doing about 3 coachings a week. Why don't you let me know in your time frame what works for you, and then I can just kind of make that work out.
Okay. Yeah. We can do that. All right. I'll let you know, man.
Loco, is this going to be a YouTube video? Because I want to be e-famous.
Oh, you want me to upload this one to YouTube?
Is it possible?
Yeah, I actually don't have a coaching session to upload this week yet. I always get people asking, like, do you ask permission if you upload these videos? I always do, so... Do I have your permission to upload this one to YouTube?
Yes, you definitely do, man. Because Doug, who's been talking smack, he's not now, but his brother is working right now, so he didn't get to watch it, and I didn't record it or anything like that, so that'd be great.
Yeah, yeah, I will probably upload it around Thursday or Friday or so. It's Tuesday right now, yeah, so probably a Thursday or Friday.
Yeah. Sweet. All right, thanks, Loco. Take care, and I'll be in contact.
Yeah, let me know, man, how it goes. All right.
All right.
Talk to you later.
Bye.